I need to take a break from this portable Pi project. There's two questions that keep coming up from the pull-up resistors tutorial. Why not just use a wire? And what's the right value to pick for the resistor? In this Adams Electronics tutorial, I'll answer both of those questions. So let's go pick. First, if you haven't watched it already, check out the full tutorial on pull-up resistors. You can find a link in the description or use the card above to take you there. Just remember to come back when you're done. As a quick review, if we have a microcontroller pin and a push button with the button connected to ground, the input pin is left in a floating state when the button is not pressed. This means the pin will randomly read as high or low. A pull-up resistor pulls the signal to a known state. I recommend picking values between 1 kiloohm and 100 kiloohms, but why? And why use a resistor at all? Why not just tie the floating pin directly to the supply? If we use the wire, we could say the resistance is 0 ohms, which is also an electric short. While that would be a strong pull-up, there's a problem. When the button is pressed, it creates a short circuit between the supply and ground. That's bad. Very bad. The resistor prevents this short. Okay, let's go look at the other extreme. Without something there, the pin floats. Another way to think of this is an open, which could be considered infinite ohms. Side note, technically an open is not infinite. Air and the PCB solder mask all have some resistance associated with them. But for our discussion, we're just gonna call it infinite. Well, a range of 0 to infinity isn't very helpful, is it? That's why I say pick between 1K and 100K. But I know you wanna know, where am I getting those numbers? So let's take a look at an example, the ATmega 328. This is the processor in the Arduino Uno. Its datasheet says its internal pull-up resistors are rated between 20 and 50 kiloohms. Let's just round that up to 100 kiloohms. As for the low end, the 1 kiloohm, that's just from my experience, but stick with me on that. On our chart, now we have a more reasonable range to pick from. But I know, you still want an actual number and like the math that goes behind it. Here's why I keep sticking to ranges. A large resistance value is called a weak pull-up, and small values are called strong pull-ups. Now, to me, that sounds backwards, but the reason is that the lower resistance values allow more current to flow, making the pull to the supply stronger. Your design determines the exact value to use. Like all things in engineering, there are trade-offs to consider. A weak pull-up that is too big starts to look like an open, which makes the pin start to float. The downside to a strong pull-up or smaller value is that when the button is pressed, the resistor burns more power, which means wasted energy. If you're using a battery, you might want to be using larger resistors. So again, it depends on your application. So a specific case that I see this problem with like the 50 kiloohm internal pull-ups is with I2C. If the wires or traces connecting a sensor are too long, you might need a strong pull-up, which means a smaller value. In review, unless you have a specific reason for another value, I suggest using something between 1K and 10K. Go up to 100K if you're using batteries. The actual value is not all that critical. You don't need a complex formula or detailed explanation. Pick the resistor that works. It really is that simple. Thank you for watching another Adams Electronics tutorial. If you have questions about pull-up resistors, leave them with this video. Check out adams.com for show notes, links to other stuff, and a link to our Discord. For now, I'm going to get back to my Raspberry Pi project. In the meantime, remember, if your circuit isn't working, just add ohms. You know, between 1 and 100K.